Highlanders Football Club followers believe that the Dynamo's equalizer was not legitimate and should have been ruled offside. Long after the match has gone, the events of the unfortunate Sunday remain on the lips of many who predominantly believe that the far side assistant got it wrong when he allowed the Dynamo's goal to stand.
I was in the game on Sunday, and from my point of view, what I saw was, I thought when the Dynamo did score, I thought it was an offside, and I was waiting for the referee, so the lineman, to indicate as such. But I was perplexed, like most of the people that were in there, that the decision went Dynamo's way.
In simple terms, the law says the defender has to play or demonstrate an intention to play the ball. Now, obviously, that has to be through the body language of the player. In my perspective, there was no intention by the defender, Peter Mbua, to play that ball. I do not know where then our pundits rush to say that the new rule vindicates them and Highlanders is at fault.
Sunday, umuntu was offside. Akula muntu ongabonanga ukuthi umlana wayeku offside. Even lo mthetho u-section 11 kuthi ibhora ingadeflector ku defend, it's an offside. Now u-section 11 akasamlandelanga, ibhora ethi deflectile. Yena wathi onside.
Former Zimbabwe Football Association referees committee chairperson Andumiso Gumede believes that according to the rules, both current and previous, the Dynamo's goal should not have been allowed to stand.
No, there would be no rule that would have allowed that goal to stand. In that incident, one clearly sees that the offending player took his time to come from the attack and remained behind. However, the ball then rebounded towards the Highlanders' goal, and it deflected past one of the Highlanders' defenders and went to that guy who was in an offside position. That point is indisputable. He was in an offside position. The big problem we have is, should he have been penalized? And my own personal view is, yes, he should have been penalized. Because even the addition that was done last year clearly says he would not be penalized if the ball was deliberately played to him by a defender. In this case, it was not deliberately played to him by the defender.
Indeed, another look at the incident would seem to suggest that Peter Mudua's contact with the ball is not a deliberate attempt to play the ball in the direction of his goal. Mudua, according to the images of the incident available, clearly is flat-footed as the ball makes contact with his foot and only reacts after the ball has bounced off his foot. That is why the Highlanders fans argue that Mudua's contact was a deflection and not a deliberate intention to play back the ball to either his goalkeeper or his teammate behind him.
In my humble opinion, it was a deflection. I think any straight-thinking person would know what a deliberate kick towards the offending player would have looked like. Let us suppose for a moment that the defending player tried to kick that ball to his goalkeeper, and the player who was in an offside position then took advantage. It would not have been declared a penalizable offside position. But in this case, the ball deflected. In other words, there is no attempt on the defending player to deliberately play the ball into the path of the attacking player.
But that's Gumede's opinion and not the official opinion that counts. Yes, Gumede has been the chairperson of the referees committee and would obviously not head such an important portfolio if his knowledge of the rules were questionable. However, it is Kusosa's opinion that matters over and above that of Gumede and anybody else. By the events of the incident that caused the termination of the match, Kusosa's opinion is that Mudua's contact with the ball was deliberate, hence a poba was played onside. On this occasion, it would appear the assistant referee is offside with his opinion.
There's a proviso in that rule that says, in the opinion of the referee. And that is a very difficult interpretation to put across. in the opinion of the referee. So if the referee thinks in his opinion it was deliberate, that's his opinion.
So that being the case, what then do the Pozo fans believe would be a fair redress of the unfortunate incident that occurred on Sunday? Already their team has been summoned for a hearing next Tuesday.
There will be times when the disciplinary committee must consider all the factors therein. In my view, this is a typical game where the principle of force majeure must be applied. In other words, it was not the players of Highlanders who walked off causing the abandonment of the game, but it was the atmosphere in there. It's like if there had been a downpour, rain, or as would have happened if it had gotten so dark and Bulawayo City Council refused to put on the lights and the game got abandoned. It's called force majeure.
So what then happens when the situation is a force majeure?
If it is considered a force majeure, the game would then have to be replayed. And it would start on the 42nd minute of the first half. Go for 4 minutes, go to halftime and play the 45. However, the discretion is with the disciplinary committee. And if the disciplinary committee begin to say, this is how Highlanders people have always acted, they must now be punished to show the others that this thing is totally unacceptable, then the decision will not have been rational.
I personally believe that that match should be replayed. I think that would be the fairest. Because it was not the fault of the teams that created the problem. It was the fault of the official who officiated that game. So the blame must lie squarely on him. And it should, whatever decision is made should not benefit one of the teams. The fairest would be to get the game to be replayed.
Akulungiswe one indaba yabo ref. Two, in neutral venue. Three, ingabi la ma supporters. Ngokubona kwami lokho.
I think we need to go by the rule book. Obviously, there have been incidents in the past, and obviously precedences have been set. But I think the most important thing is for sober minds and go by the rule book and throw away any emotional decisions that may come our way.
Should the game be replayed, many factors would then come into question. Amongst some of them are whether the fans should be allowed into the match or not. There are also those that believe it should be played at a neutral venue. The other factor is whether the game should commence from the first minute or should it be resumed from the time when it was abandoned. If so, should the Dynamo's goal be allowed to stand or not? Food for thought.
That's another tricky one, because once the referee has allowed the game to, the ball has deemed that the ball has been declared a goal, unless he changes his mind before the ball is kicked at the halfway center, he is allowed to change his mind. So there are many options here. If there is a general feeling that, no, it can't have been deemed a goal, then the decision will be it's not a goal, it will be played there as offside and start there. However, if the referee says, I was impeded in going to the center, I would have been going there anyway. That's another situation.
This is not the first time that crowd trouble has caused the abandonment of a match at Baba Fields, but all hope is not lost on that it be the last. For it to be, it would be important to interrogate the causes of violence so that the authorities that be act ahead of what is a damaging cause to the football brand. The Pozo family has made it clear that they are not happy with a particular official seemingly married to handle most of their matches.
The club should make an effort to complain to the powers that be, that it seems like there is a deliberate ploy to deploy the same referee in our case. And we wonder why. But already there was a precedent that was set by Dynamo. I can't remember when they were supposed to play Wanke, and the referee was supposed to be had life and death, and they said they were not going to go to the stadium if he was appointed. And he was removed. Whilst we may not win, obviously we don't condone violence, but let us not be provoked into it.
How do you explain the fact that
that Dynamos refused to have Hadley Ndazi officiating their matches, and he doesn't officiate in their matches. Dynamos do not want Hadley Ndazi. Islanders do not want Kusosa. But Kusosa has come to officiate Islanders 3 times in the last 7 matches. In the last 7 matches, Hadley Ndazi has not officiated at Dynamos. What gives Dynamos the capacity and the power to determine who officiates in their matches and who does not? Yet other PXL clubs of similar stature do not have that privilege.
Beautiful apana. Umdlalwana omnandi kakhulu, umdlalwana umuhle kakhulu. I problem esilayo eZimbabwe online men labo ref. Ikakhulu ngizaphambanisa, ngizaxolisa ngokuqamba igama. Online men ukusosa. Indodalwana akaqali ukwenza into eziyazi njani. Sesijayele insuku zonke and ukwenza against Highland. Angazi ukuthi ama obhosi bakhe abakunanzeleli yini.
There should be no place for violence and its hooligans in our game. It must be condemned in a collective effort, and all stakeholders ought to come together and unite to eradicate the biggest enemy to the game. Missile throwing has no place in our football. Even Boso followers agree that those who perpetrate acts of misconduct which tarnish the image of the game must be brought to book.
I observed on Sunday that a particular individual repeatedly invades the pitch. 1, 2, 3, 4 times. And the police are there, they don't apprehend that particular individual and deal with him according to the law. What does that imply? One particular supporter was actually apprehended by the supporters themselves behind the Soweto goalpost, but inside the pitch. Why did the police not take advantage and grab that guy and prosecute him?
Hi, look at Ekiniswini, Akulunga. Eqinisweni akulunganga and futhi asikukhuthali. Siyakucela asikukhuthazi. Siyacela lani Mandebele. Alike lime lani sibone ukuthi kanti vele kuzaphitha ngani. Singahambeli phambili.
Unfortunate that it degenerated to that level. But people must understand football is a very, very emotional game. I remember Zinedine Zidane hitting another player who he thought had insulted him. Football is like that. But we as administrators keep telling our supporters that they must expect any one of three results, a win, a draw, or a loss. And even if you have lost a game, there is no reason to be violent. And particularly in this case, where there's a pitch invasion and the referee's almost molested, that is unacceptable. The referees are often told of law number 18, which is interpreted as saying, use your common sense. If your action is going to cause lots of problems, make sure you try and take a decision that will not incense people.
Tuesday, the 23rd of May, D-Day then for Highlanders, but there is a feeling it's high time all stakeholders faced the reality that they share some measure of responsibility for the disturbances. The fans, the police, PSL and Zifa, marshals, the sports commission and security companies must all accept that they have a fair share of responsibility. To punish Highlanders alone has not proven the most suitable solution, and so it is not a solution.
There are many other factors that affect the emotions at the ground and perceived or not real. It is prudent to take those things into effect.
The rule that whenever there is violence at Highlanders matches, all other stakeholders still smile all the way to the bank, whether they have done their job well or not, whilst the boss or face the music alone, must be revisited. It has not brought desired results up to now. There is no evidence that it will, nor is there any proof that other stakeholders are doing enough to eradicate hooliganism, yet all the time it's Highlanders that is fined. Maybe this time around, let's interrogate the part that other stakeholders would have played to save the situation, if not the part they play to contribute towards the mess.
Out there, there is a suspicion that whenever there are disturbances at Highlanders Football Club and matches, it's payday for some fellas, and to keep the job, somebody has to incite and maintain the chaos. It is indeed a mischievous point to ponder, but until we appreciate the fact that it is not a Highlanders problem alone, the solution to the mess is far-fetched. Tanzania Zimbabwe Television Sports Media, Bulawayo.